Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the App Connect Enterprise team. In this video, I will demonstrate how to use policies in App Connect Enterprise version 11. I will be accessing data from a DB2 database on Windows from a message flow running in App Connect Enterprise on a Mac. I will use a JDBC provider policy to define the connection details to the database. I will also show how values in the policy can be overridden. In App Connect Enterprise version 11, a new first-class artifact called Policy Project has been added. You can create multiple policies within a policy project. In this video, I'm creating a JDBC provider policy to access a DB2 database. I will specify the connection details in the policy. I have copied the required DB2 jar files to my Mac. And I need to specify the directory that contains them. I will specify a security identifier that can be used to look up the user ID and password to connect to the database. Policies can be referenced from message flow nodes. I'm going to reference the JDBC provider policy from a Java Compute node. I have a simple flow that processes a HTTP request and accesses the database using a Java Compute node. The Java Compute node references the policy when setting up the JDBC connection. I have explicitly specified the policy project and policy name. I need to connect to the database using a user ID and password. I will store these details using MQSI setdb params. MQSI setdb params uses the same work directory that is used by the integration server. The security identifier that I specified in the policy matches the security identifier that is used with MQSI setdb params. I'll start a new integration server and connect to it from the toolkit. I'll create a new bar file. I'll add the application containing the message flow to the bar file. I'll also add the policy project to the bar file. I have already started an integration server. I can deploy the bar file directly to the integration server. I'll send a test message using the flow exerciser. The flow failed to connect to the database. The policy was using connection details for a machine used by the application developer. As an administrator, I need to override the policy values to use a different machine that is hosting the database. I can do this by copying the policy to the overrides directory and then change the host name that is in the policy. You can also export the policy project from the toolkit or your version control system. The policy in the overrides directory will now be used by the message flow. The integration server must be restarted for overrides to take effect. I can now resend the message. I now see the flow connected successfully to the database and returned data from it. In this video, I have shown how to create a policy and reference it. I have also shown how to override a value in it. Policy projects can be added to a bar file and deployed directly to an integration server. This simplifies configuring your integration solution.